and Marianne in particular have learned how to be competitive and put their fears aside. They are going to continue to improve, but I think the biggest part is they're not letting those fears get in the way of their competition. If you watched in all of Marianne's races, she made a move to win all three of them. And short of getting passed in the last 100 meters by a couple of people, she would have had three victories. So as a sophomore, I think she's going to continue to learn, continue to be more competitive, and learn how to run races just a, maybe a little bit better. There's not a lot of room for improvement, but there's some. Simi's the same thing. She's just, when she gets to nationals, she is locked in. She is competitive and going for that victory, and she's not letting other things get in the way. We were a little bit hindered going in there. Cindy Wong has had a Achilles tendon issue going into this, well, basically the whole season since cross country, and she's managed that throughout the season, but the last 3 weeks she's been unable to really perform, train at a normal level. So backing off of workouts, backing off of running, doing a lot of cross training, we knew that she was not going to be at her full capabilities. Hannah Chen was excellent, had a, for a freshman in particular at that level, went out maybe a little too hard, but she was very competitive. And Christina just got boxed in that 1200, so she wasn't able to run her best performance. It's the first time I've seen a 1200 leg of a DMR turn into a strategic leg, which was a little unfortunate, but they put Marianne in a good enough position that she could get the job done. In the trials, he ran a pretty flawless race. He got in front, so he stayed out of trouble. When the race accelerated towards the end, a couple people passed him, but that was okay because he only needed to be one of the top three. And he ran a 59 last 400 to put himself in contention to go to the final. So the trials were actually pretty much flawless. In the finals, I think the stress of the situation fatigued him a little bit, not the actual running. It was a much faster pace in the finals. He did get caught on the rail, but he pulled outside with, after 1,000 meters, he made a nice move from inside out. And if he would have kept that, if he had been able to continue that, he would have been in position to do very well. But for whatever reason, whether it was mental or physical fatigue, once he got about halfway through the pack, he, I think, sort of checked himself, and then he ended up back in the back again. States went out a little too fast in the leadoff leg of that relay for the first 200. He got the break. He did a great job with that. Expended a little bit too much energy. He was 22.4 at the first 200 of that 400, and when he got to the 300 mark, there wasn't a whole lot left, and so he ended up getting passed just as they were handing off. Derek left a tad too early, had to cut his momentum to actually receive the baton, and a second team passed. So now we were in third place going into that, and Derek ran a strong leg, but we were in third place, and it's very difficult to pass once you get in that position. The handoff to Sam was an exact duplicate of what happened to Derek, in that Sam got off a little too quickly, had to slow down. By the time he got the baton, another team had passed, and we were in last, a fourth out of four, going into that final leg. Michael Cava's Achilles tendon is in the same boat as Cindy's, if not worse. So he can, if he was competitive, if he had been in it, he could have probably persevered. But once he saw he wasn't making ground, I'm sure that got to him mentally, and he kind of gave up in the last 100 meters. So unfortunately, that meant they didn't place, even though they're a very strong relay team. There needs to be possibly a little more passion, but definitely a little bit better handoffs going into the outdoor season. Well, Abby did a pretty good job. She, first time at Nationals, she cleared her opening height on the first attempt, so that was strong. Mm-hmm. Didn't vault as well as she would like at the next height, so could she have been All-American? Possibly, if she cleared her second and then the third height, which she's fully capable of. Arinze had, his heel was bothering him. He'd hurt his heel a few days earlier going into Nationals. I think his nerves got to him a little bit. He was probably a little too hyped up, but between his heel and maybe being a little too excited, it changed his approach, and so his mark was off, and both his second and third jump he fouled and didn't make it. what we're looking at is mostly experience. For whatever reason, when we get to these nationals, some of the people, if they're there for the first time, have a difficult time maintaining their same composure that they've had all season. So going into outdoors, hopefully they both would be able to make nationals again. This experience that they had indoors should carry over a little bit and allow them to perform a little bit better. A slow start. We're pretty beat up. We've got quite a few little injuries that we're going to have to take care of. Once those folks are back, we should be okay come end of April, early May. But early April might not look so good from a team perspective. And that's okay, because we want to be ready for those championships. And we have to be very patient, come around slowly, so that when we get there, we're fresh and we're ready to go. I think if we are healthy, you should expect conference championships. You should expect New England Division III championships from both teams, which they both won last year. And nationals, you know, it's hard to say. That's such a competitive situation that it's very difficult to say what's going to get in, what's not. I think the women have a reasonable shot at getting on the podium, and even more importantly, possibly, is placing high enough that they are given the program of the in the country for Division III and getting the Verkaderen Cup, because we are certainly in the lead at this point after cross country and indoor. And I believe the men, if they get things together, can certainly be top 10.